Hi friends, welcome to Sada Learning Hub. You are with me, Sadashiv Rao. Today's session, we are going to learn set data type in a Python. See here, a set. In this video, I'm going to cover about what is the set, what are the how to create the set, what are the different methods, and how to do the operations on the set. A set object is an unordered collection of distinct hash table objects. It has commonly used in a membership testing, removing the duplicates from a sequence, and computing mathematical operations such as intersections, unions, differences, and semantic differences. These are all done by using the sets only. A set object is an unordered collection of a distinct hash table objects. It is a commonly used in a membership testing, removing the duplicates from a sequence and computing mathematical operations such as intersections, unions, differences, and symmetric differences. Set supports x in the set length of the set and for x in the set like other collections. Set is an unordered collection and does not record elements' positions or order of insertions. Set do not support indexing, slicing, and other sequencing like behaviors. See here, set doesn't support the indexing, slicing, and other sequences like behaviors. There are currently two built-in set types, set and frozen set. See here, the Python supports currently two built-in set types, set and frozen sets. The set type is immutable. The contents can be changed using the method like add method and remove method. Since it is mutable, it has no hash value and cannot be used as either a directory key or as an elements or another set. The frozen set type is an immutable and hash table. Its contents cannot be altered after its creation. Why? Because it is an immutable. It can be therefore be used as in a directory key or an elements of another set. See here, the Python supports currently two types of built-in set types. The first one is a set and the second one is a frozen set. The set type is an mutable. The content can be changed using the method like add method and remove method. Since it is a mutable, it has no hash values and cannot be used as either directory key or as an element or another set. The frozen type is a immutable and it has a hash table. Its contents cannot be altered after it is created. It can be therefore be used a dictionary key or as an element of another set. Now, if you want to create the set, we can use to create the set. If you see, this is the way to create the set. There is a different built-in methods are available: pop method, remove method, discard method, and add method. Now, I'm going to discuss how to do the operations on the sets. How to do operations on the sets intersections, unions, differences, and symmetric differences, and all those how to do by using the sets. I will show you one example on this. See here, I'm showing the one example for that. See, this is an example. In this example, I'm creating the set at here. See, this is the way to create a set. Set x is equal to, I'm creating a set. After that, I'm printing the set. Now, I'm assigning the value. I'm inserting the values into the set while creating n is equal to set of. I'm inserting the values at here 0 to 5. I'm inserting the values. After that, I'm printing the values at here. Now, the one more is, now I am try to iterating my set by using, I'm creating one set it here. I'm iterating the set by using the for loop. I'm giving the num set. It iterates each and every number. It will be given to store into the n and it will be printed into the here. This is the way to iterate our set. Next, how to add the element into the set. If you want to add the element to the set, now I am creating an empty set at here. After creating an empty set, I am going to add adding dynamically color set dot add method. This add method takes an takes an value and it will be stored it into the set. Now the add method is used to add the values into the set. Now if you see, if you want to update the values, just use the color dot add. If you want to update the, if you want to add the multiple values at a time into your set, if you can use it like this, set dot color set dot update. The update method, it will be used to add the multiple values into your set. Next, now you know how to create the set and how to traverse the set. Now just know, you know about how to add the single value and how to add the multiple values into the set. Now your turn is know how to remove the values from the set. If you want to remove the values from the set, just use the method pop method. The pop method, it is used to delete the first element from the set. It is used to delete the first element in the set. If you want to delete a particular index, particular element into your set, just you can use the method called remove method. The remove method is used to remove the particular index value. See here, I'm giving it remove the value is 0. Now whatever if you are saying the it will be search for the not index, it will be search for the value 0. If it is available, it is removed from the index. Now if you want to discard, this will also use to discard the value from the set. This is the way to remove the elements from the set. You can use the pop method, or we can use the remove method, or we can use the discard method. All these methods are used to remove the elements from the set. Next, intersection of the set. Now if you want to check the intersection of the set, I am creating the two sets here. The first set contains green and blue. The second set contains blue and yellow. Now I am going to check what is the intersection of the two sets, means blue. It going to give the blue as an intersection of the set. It returns the, it creates one more set and it will be written green, blue as a intersection set value. Next one is union of sets. Union means I'm creating the two sets, how mathematical union works, intersection works like that. Here also it is going to work same like that only. Now here this is the union. Whenever you are doing like this, it will be union of these two sets, means green, blue, yellow. It will be give you a three values into a separate set A. And coming to differences, if you want to find the differences between the two sets, now we can use the minus symbol. It will be give what are the differences between the two sets, that is the green and yellow. And coming to the symmetric differences, if you want to know the symmetric differences between the two sets, just use a cap symbol. It will be give the symmetric differences between the two sets. Next, issue subset and is superset. If you check the is subset and is superset, you can use the less than or equal to and greater than or equal to. It will be written the separate sets that are the subset and the supersets. And I'm going to little more dig into the sets. If you use the less than or equal to and greater than or equal to, this is the things. And the shallow copy means if you want to copy the one set into the another set, there is a different copies are available. Here is the shallow copy. It will be used to copy the one set into the another set. If you see, I'm copying set X into the set D. Now if you see, if you want to clear the set, just use the clear method. It will be clear the set. These are the different these are the way to use the sets into your program, into the Python program. If you see, this is the output. Now in Red Hat and all those things, this is the intersection, union, and symmetric differences and all differences and all those things result at displayed at here. Now this is the way to create the set. After that we are discussing how to iterate the set. Next, after that we are checking adding the members into the set. Okay, if can it is possible to add the single value and the multiple values. After that, how to remove the elements from the set. This is the way to remove the elements from the set. Next, we are going to discuss about how to intersection of the sets. After that, union, how to do the union of the sets, and how to show the differences between the sets. And next, we are getting the how to do the symmetric differences between the sets. And after that, we are checking each subset and each superset. Those are the subsets and the superset. After that, how to copy the set, shallow copy. And finally, we are learn how to do clear the set. These are the different. These are the way to use the set into your Python programs. Python program. Next video, I am going to discuss about a directories. Now, in this video, next video, I discussed about the directories, how to create the directory and how to do the operations on the directory and all those things. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel sa.learninghub because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.